Hello and welcome. Today we are going to start with our new chapter, that is rights. In this chapter we will discuss about various political rights, economic and social rights and its ever expanding nature. We will also do the meaning of the rights and on what basis the rights are claimed and what purpose do rights serve us and why are they so much important. So let us start with first thing, that what do you mean by rights? Rights ek tarah de justified claim hai. And this is, it denotes what we are entitled to as citizens. Ek citizens de taur te sanu kede kede claims mile gaye ne government di taraf se, oh sare assi rights de vich rakhange. These are primarily those claims that I along with others regard to be necessary for leading a life of respect and dignity. ਜੇਕਰ ਅਸੀਂ ਇੱਕ ਹਿਊਮਨ ਬੀਂਗ ਇੱਕ ਇੰਡੀਵਿਜੁਅਲ ਰਿਸਪੈਕਟ ਅਤੇ ਡਿਗਨਿਟੀ ਦੀ ਲਾਈਫ ਜੀਣਾ ਚਾਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ, ਵਟ ਵਰ ਦ ਡਿਗਨੀਫਾਈਡ ਐਂਡ ਡਿਗਨੀਫਾਈਡ ਲਿਵਿੰਗ ਦੇ ਲਈ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਜਸਟੀਫਾਈਡ ਕਲੇਮਸ ਨੇ ਗਵਰਨਮੈਂਟ ਦੇ ਥਰੂ ਗਵਰਨਮੈਂਟ ਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ, ਦੈਟ ਆਰ ਰਾਈਟਸ. ਅਗਰ ਆਪ ਯੂਨੀਫਾਰਮ ਕੀ ਐਗਜ਼ਾਮਪਲ ਲੇ ਯਹਾਂ ਪਰ, ਦਿਸ ਡਜ਼ਨਟ ਮੀਨ ਦੈਟ ਯੂ ਵਿਲ ਸ਼ੋ ਦਿਸ ਥਿੰਗ ਦੈਟ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਹੈਵਿੰਗ ਦ ਰਾਈਟ ਟੂ ਵੇਅਰ ਯੋਰ ਕੈਜੂਅਲ ਡਰੈਸ in the school while instead of school uniform. You can't claim. These are justified only, justification bhi honi chahiye, or you will not be allowed to wear casual clothes in the school. You have to wear the school uniform. Aap kabhi, aapka ye haq hai ki aap ghar se dur late night tak bahar rehna chahte hain, lekin iska ye matlab nahi hai कि आपको स्कूल में बिना यूनिफॉर्म के एंटर करने दिया जाएगा. स्कूल में आपको यूनिफॉर्म डालनी ही पड़ेगी और आप इसको अपना राइट नहीं मान सकते हैं. सो व्हाट फॉर एग्जांपल राइट टू लाइवलीहुड मे बी कंसिडर्ड नेसेसरी फॉर लीडिंग अ डिग्निफाइड लाइफ. क्योंकि अगर आपके पास इकोनॉमिकली, इफ़ यू आर स्ट्रॉन्ग, यू आर इकोनॉमिकली, इकोनॉमिक इंडिपेंडेंस इज देयर, इन दैट सिचुएशन ओनली यू कैन मीट, you can acquire freedom, you can develop your talents, you can develop your interest. And if you are creative, in a sense, if you are good at music, dance, writing or any other creative activity, only in that situation you can develop your potential. Aap apne sare skills ko develop kar sakte hain agar aap economic way mein independent hain. So that is why right to livelihood, it is one of the universal rights. In the same way, free expression of beliefs and opinion, that has also been important right in the democratic government. So there are certain rights like right to livelihood, right to freedom of expression. These are all important human rights and these are described as universal in nature. इनको यूनिवर्सल भी कहा जाता है, यूनिवर्सल क्लेम्स भी कहे जाते हैं गवर्नमेंट के ऊपर जो कि एक इंडिविजुअल मांग करता है. नाउ द क्वेश्चन राइजेस दैट ऑन व्हाट ग्राउंड, ऑन व्हाट बेसिस दीज राइट्स आर क्लेम. व्हाट आर द वेरियस बेसिस ऑन व्हिच दीज राइट्स आर क्लेम. द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज दैट दे आर नेसेसरी फॉर अवर वेलबींग, फॉर द वेलफेयर ऑफ द सोसाइटी, फॉर द वेलबींग ऑफ द इंडिविजुअल्स and citizens. These are very very important and they also help individuals to help their talents and skills. Individuals ko apne talents wo jis bhi tarah ka, kyunki agar unko right milega, I have given you earlier example also that agar unko economically right to livelihood milta hai to wo apne talents aur interest ko, potential ko develop kar payenge. So these rights are also helpful in developing the talents and skills. For example, right to education, that has been given to each and every individual. This is one of the universal right in whole of the world nowadays and it has helped to develop our capacity to reason, gives us useful skills. If we have right to education, we can think in a reasonable manner, we can develop our skills, we can make our informed choices in our life. That is why universal right education, right to education, it has been given a status of universal right in whole of the world. Agar right to education aapka right hai, it doesn't mean that you will demand for those rights which can be injurious to your health and your well-being and to those persons who are living around you. For example, medical research, they have shown, it has shown that prohibited drugs, they are injurious to one's health and they also affect the their relations with others. You can't claim that I must have the right to smoking because I cannot live without it. Right to smoking ka adhikar diya jaye, because you can't be given this kind of rights because you know very well that these drugs, they not only injure your health, but it also sometimes change your behavior patterns and make us a danger to other people also, those who are living around you. In terms of education, in terms of rights, smoking and taking banned drugs, they cannot be claimed as a right. राइट के लिए आपको ये, आप ये नहीं मान सकते कि आप अगर अपनी मनमर्जी के कपड़े डालना चाहते हैं तो आप स्कूल में भी कैजुअल ड्रेसेस डालकर चले जाएंगे. देयर यू हैव टू वेयर द यूनिफॉर्म ओनली एंड यू कांट क्लेम दैट दिस आई कांट लिव विदाउट दिस ड्रग, दिस गिव मी ईज एंड कम्फर्ट, दैट इज वाई इट इज माई राइट टू टेक दिस ड्रग. नो, अकॉर्डिंग टू द थ्योरी ऑफ डेफिनेशंस ऑफ राइट्स, smoking and taking of the banned drugs, they cannot be claimed as a right. Now the next part of the chapter is, where do rights come from? Rights kahan se aate hain, kahan se inka origin hua hai? In 17th and 18th century, if we talk about 17th and 18th century, the political theorists, they used to give their arguments that these rights are given to us by nature or God. And that is why these rights are inalienable, they are inseparable, they cannot be taken away from you. Some of the three natural rights, inko natural rights isliye kaha gaya tha because they were derived from natural law. And three natural rights of human beings are right to life, right to liberty, right to property. Right to life, under this livelihood and other rights will come. Liberty is the right of freedom, and under property one is able to own the property. So these were the three natural rights, and they were having this idea that it is a powerful notion and it has no state or no government, no organization should take away whatever has been given by the law of nature. Natural rights ke under ye jo tino rights provide kiye gaye hain human beings ko, that cannot be taken away, that cannot be taken away by any state or government. But in recent years, after the developments, human rights, they are being used more as the term natural rights. Natural rights ki jagah human rights ko naam diya gaya hai. These are increasing, and human rights, human beings themselves seek or arrive at an order to lead a minimal good life. Kyunki yahi wo rights hain jo ki ek minimally good life ko enjoy karne mein hamari madad karte hain. Aur ye mana jata hai that human beings, every human being, he is unique and equally valuable. And that is why all persons are equal and no one is born to serve others. In the same way, हर एक human being की अपनी dignity होती है, वो unique है, and he is equally valuable to the society, and no person is born to do the service of others. In the same way, United Nations Declaration of Human Rights के अंडर United Nations Universal Declaration of Human Rights, it builds up this understanding of rights It attempts to recognize those claims that the world community collectively sees as being important for leading a life of dignity and self-respect. यूनिवर्सल डिक्लेरेशन जो ह्यूमन राइट्स की यूएन के द्वारा दी गई है उसमें हर व्यक्ति की अपनी एक इंट्रिंसिक क्वालिटी एक वैल्यू होती है एंड वी मस्ट हैव इक्वल अपॉर्चुनिटीज टू बी फ्री एंड रियलाइज अवर फुल पोटेंशियल. हर एक व्यक्ति यूनिक है और उसको किसी दूसरे की सेवा करने के लिए नहीं हम छोड़ सकते. दैट इज़ वाई स्लेवरी हैज़ बीन अबॉलिश्ड सर्टेन untouchability has been abolished from the from India. Apartheid has been abolished from South Africa, and these were certain steps that were taken to give the dignity to the human beings. And moreover, the scope of human rights, it is ever expanding. It is expanding nowadays. New threats and challenges are being faced by our Indian society and the world society. For example, there are certain demands for rights to clean air, water, sustainable development. Especially new awareness about the changes about especially women, children or the sick face in times of war and natural crisis has also led to the demands for right to livelihood, right of children and others' rights. Like children before 14 years, they should not be given access to the hazardous job. Bob Geldof की एक अपील है जिसमें उसने वेस्टर्न गवर्नमेंट को कहा है कि वो अफ्रीका की पॉवर्टी को दूर करने का प्रयास करे. एंड दिस टीवी रिपोर्ट्स हैव gained a large scale of support from ordinary people all over the world. So कुछ हमारी नई नई challenges, कई threats society को face करने पड़ रहे हैं. उसी के कारण ही हमें नए rights, बिल्कुल new rights लोगों को प्रदान करने पड़ रहे हैं governments को. For example, ozone layer की depletion हो रही है. Heat is increasing day by day through chlorofluorocarbons and forests, their count has been decreasing day by day. So it is ever expanding. The scope of rights is it is ever expanding. And let us start with our Immanuel Kant on human dignity. What does he say? Immanuel Kant, in his famous quote, he says that everything has a price or a dignity. What has a price is such that something else can also be put in its place. एक हर एक चीज का प्राइस है और उसकी जगह कोई और ले सकता है. हमेशा ही उसको रिप्लेस किया जा सकता है. As its equivalent, by contrast, that which is elevated above all price and admits on of no equivalent has a dignity. But there are certain persons there can they cannot be they have so high dignity that they cannot be replaced for anything. For example, your mother, you can't replace your mother with any other individual in whole of the world. He was a German philosopher from 18th century. He gave us the simple idea through his simple meaning. For him, every person has dignity. उन्होंने जो आइडिया दिया उनके अकॉर्डिंगली हर एक पर्सन की अपनी डिग्निटी है. And they should be seen as just as a human being. Whether that person is an uneducated person or a poor person or a powerless person or a dishonest or immoral person, every person is equal. He has a dignity. And that is why he should be treated as a virtue of being human being. He deserves to be given some minimum dignity. He presents his moral conception of ideas, and under that he gave us two arguments. Under his first argument, he says that we should be treating others as we would like to be treated ourselves. एक ह्यूमन बीइंग को हमें उस तरह से ट्रीट करना चाहिए जिस तरह से हम चाहते हैं कि वो ह्यूमन बीइंग हमें ट्रीट करे. जैसा आप स्वभाव, जिस बिहेवियर की आप आशा दूसरों के साथ रखते हैं, दूसरों के प्रति रखते हैं, वैसा ही बिहेवियर आपको दूसरों के साथ करना चाहिए. एंड यू शुड ऑल्सो मेक श्योर दैट वी डोंट ट्रीट द अदर पर्सन एज मीन्स टू अवर एंड्स. किसी और के साथ अपने प्रॉफिट, अपने एडवांटेज के लिए ही बात करनी, ये ठीक नहीं है. बिकॉज दैट पर्सन इज़ अ ह्यूमन बीइंग, उसको एक कार, हॉर्स या पेन की तरह ट्रीट करना बिल्कुल ठीक नहीं है. एंड वी ऑट टू रिस्पेक्ट पीपल नॉट बिकॉज दे आर यूजफुल टू अस बट दे आर आफ्टर ऑल ह्यूमन बीइंग्स. हमें ह्यूमन बीइंग्स की रिस्पेक्ट इस कारण करनी चाहिए क्योंकि वो एक व्यक्ति है, ह्यूमन बीइंग है, क्रिएशन ऑफ गॉड है, इसलिए नहीं कि वो हमारे कितने यूजफुल है. उसका यूजफुल होना हमारे लिए इतना मायने नहीं रखता, जबकि उसकी ह्यूमन डिग्निटी को देखकर ही हमें उन्हें अपना रिस्पेक्ट देना चाहिए. सो दिस वॉज ऑल इमैनुअल कांट सेज दैट अ पर्सन शुड बी रिस्पेक्टेड बिकॉज ही इज हैविंग ह्यूमन डिग्निटी, ही इज हैविंग अ सॉर्ट ऑफ डिग्निटी, एंड दैट इज वाई he should be respected, not because that he is of, we are having any use to, we, that person is useful to us. हमें एक person की respect, उसके usefulness, उसके advantage, उनसे हमें क्या profit होना है, उसके accordingly नहीं करनी चाहिए, जबकि इसलिए उसकी respect करनी चाहिए because हम ये चाहते हैं कि वो भी हमसे अच्छा व्यवहार करे और वो एक human बीइंग है, उसको एक ह्यूमन बीइंग की तरह ही रेस्पेक्ट दी जानी चाहिए. दिस इज ऑल द टुडेज पॉइंट. थैंक यू. हैव अ नाइस डे.